Or if you go like this hysteretic graphically, then the system go from the zipped state to unzipped state and unzipped state to zipped state over a cycle. And that is not a very unusual, because in case of magnetization, people do study such type of problem, where only thing, the extension whatever I am calling is replaced by the magnetization, and the force whatever I am saying is replaced by the magnetic field. And you have the oscillatory field. Vikas Chakravarty and all those, they have reported a very good review modern of physics article, so one can see this. So with this, we again do our analysis, molecular dynamic analysis, and try to see. So if you see, if your frequency is high, you try to open the polymer chain, you remain in the zipped state. You decrease the frequency, means you allow the system to grow, then you see that you are covering more area. You go on increasing, the area increases, and it reaches to its maximum. And if you further go on decreasing, then it approaches to the equilibrium force temperature. So if you go on giving them more and more time, it goes to a maximum, and then it traces the equilibrium path. It immaterials whether you are going to apply a high amplitude or a low amplitude. So if you apply the high amplitude, you start from the unzipped state phase, and then in both cases you trace the same equilibrium path. So what is important, that you see the area increases with frequency and then it decreases. So this is the feature whatever has been seen in case of magnetization also, that this A scales with h to the power alpha and omega to the power beta, and they are the universal dynamic exponent. Interestingly, the whatever the dynamical exponent has been seen there in case of magnetic system, we do find the same exponents which is appearing in the case of DNA also. So this is the thing whatever we are trying to see, that nu to the power 0.5 and f to the power 0.5, all this low frequency regime, all this scales with this. In the high frequency regime, they scales with nu to the power minus 1 f to the power square. There is some term, but it is f square. So this is the scaling whatever, as I said, it has been seen in case of magnetic system also. What is more important, experiment has been done here in the regime where I have shown that hysteresis exists. Experiments have been done in this regime also, where the equilibrium force temperature diagram has been obtained. Our suggestion is that one can perform these experiments gradually and can predict or can observe whether the exponents remain the same or not. With this word, we also said that this is not a finite size effect. We vary our simulation for different length, and we find that for length, there is another exponent appear as n to the power 0.75. And all these curves, you can collapse on a single curve if you do some sort of scaling. We can go. How much time do I have?
8 minutes.
So I will not take more than 8. So anyway, so the questions now we are going to address, are these exponents robust, means whether you are going to see all the time? Does this dynamical transition exist in the thermodynamic limit? We simplify the model by assuming that we don't go for this very complicated, whatever I have shown, the coarse grain model. You try to consider the simple model where the energy is bound with this epsilon B NP. The force term, whatever, if you open it, this is the energy contribution. And the third term, which is the force which you are applying with the distance. So that is the third term which you are applying. And now you can choose this force term, either linear ramp or you can consider as a sinusoidal wave, whatever you want to take. The choice is yours. So this gives you the freedom. The second condition, whatever we are going to take, we solve this Langevin equation. So we can drop this term. So that means the inertial term we are dropping. So simulation goes basically the Brownian dynamic simulation. And we do the simulation for all these three cases. And whatever we are trying to observe, that all these three cases gives for this model system the three different curves. But with the proper scaling, all these curves collapse on the one curve. This means dynamics is very robust, and the exponents, whatever we expect, they will remain the same. But this gives me the additional degree of freedom that I can solve this equation by dropping the inertial term. So we go one step ahead. So we take the simplest model coming from this simulation and try to solve this equation for a different omega. And whatever we can see, that if you go on decrease the omega, the curve go on increasing. So all these curves gives you the different curve, whether it is low amplitude, or if you take high amplitude, so then the curve goes like this. So if you decrease this, they are going to probe more and more. But with a suitable new XT, all these curves collapse onto the one curve. It says that if you decrease the frequency, dynamical transition doesn't exist because there is nothing like this. So all these effects, whatever we have seen, is effectively a finite size effect in the system. And it is to be noted that all the biological system is the finite size. So such transition you can expect in the space. But what is important whenever you are going to solve this equation, this is a transcendental equation, so it is not easy to solve. But under a certain approximation, if you solve, then again you can find that a loop, that is the area of the loop, goes at f square omega to the power minus 1, whatever has been seen in the experiments. So this is the analytical situation seen, which also comes into this. But the moment you put a binding on x that you have the finite x, means your extension cannot grow more than this, it means you take the finite size effect in your model system, you see that there is a dynamical transition now, that there is a high temperature phase which scales with nu to the power minus 1 f square, the low temperature phase which scales nu to the power 0.5, nu to the power 0.33, and there is a scaling also associated with the length, so we have a different scaling and whatever we see this. So this we find that, and it has been published in the Physical Review last year. So let me conclude that we briefly discussed the single molecule force spectroscopy experiments and showed that the simple model of polymer captures some of the essential physics behind the DNA. We have shown that the position of binding pocket in DNA aptamers may change the dynamics of rupture. That is very important in case of you want to design the drug and where you want to put the drug in the aptamer. We have shown for the first time the existence of dynamical transition in context of DNA. In context of magnetic system, it has been already observed, where DNA can be brought from the zipped state to the open state or a new dynamic state, which is called the hysteretic state, by changing the frequency, neither the force nor the temperature. So the frequency is the thermodynamic parameter which is appearing here, which drives your system from the one state to the another state. The another important conclusion is that in thermodynamic limit, this high frequency scaling limit extends to low frequency region. You have only one scaling, that is nu to the power minus 1 f square. And we have calculated the various scaling exponents associated with this transition and obtained the phase diagram. Thank you very much for your kind attention.